prom's not until next year, but I was thinking we should start talking dress colors, just so we don't clash in photos or anything. Thinking red or pink for myself.
Hmm, cute. I was thinking I was gonna wear a royal blue or an emerald green because I just love earthy tones.
I'm probably gonna wear yellow. Gotta stand out. That would look killer on you. What about you, Sid? Sydney, hello.
Huh? What were you talking about?
Prom dresses.
Oh! Pietro and I already done our outfits.
What? Why did you get to pick first? Why didn't you pick with us? Oh no, we're totally going to clash!
I'm wearing a white dress?
Oh, you mean for his prom this year, right?
No, Pietro and I decided we're only going to go to one prom, so it would be more special.
You really think you're going to last that long? You haven't even been dating for 3 months.
Actually, we've got a lot of things planned out. Prom attire, the names of our 3 children, where we're gonna get married, how we're gonna decorate.
What are you doing?
What?
You're my best friend and all, but as my best friend, it's my job to tell you how incredibly stupid you sound.
Kenny, I'm not stupid. I'm in love.
You're being serious.
Hold on. Pietro's calling.
Are you seriously?
Hi, Smushy Mushy Kids! I love you too! No. I love you so much! Don't even know! Wait. Seriously? Oh my god! Babe, the best news ever! Okay. I'll talk to you later. Love you!
Holy shit!
Ow! What, did he bite in the heart of the ocean?
No.
How on earth did he get here so fast?
And why are you being so dramatic? He dropped her off this morning.
Pietro, you're a senior. You don't have lunch this period. What are you doing here?
Nah, dude. Being a different grade was just too much time away from the rest of my life.
Isn't that illegal? Like, there's no valid reason for you to get held back. You're not even a bad student.
It's called love, Danny.
Yeah. Love can conquer any battle.
What is this? Some kind of horribly rated rom-com? Seriously, what are you doing here?
Are you not happy to see me?
I see you every time I go to work, and now every time I see Sydney.
Wow. Oh my god. We're gonna have so much fun. Let's arrange our schedules so that ours are identical.
Oh baby, yes!
Let's go!
Well, there goes one of our quartets. Man, he's freaking Yoko Ono.
Oh no, does that mean our friend group's falling apart?
Anna, don't be ridiculous. Just think, they're happy now. They'll get over each other eventually. Will they?
Sydney, you don't like cookies. Since love his cookies. Oh my gosh. Babe, did you make this for me?
Yeah, it was from the box, but I guess you could say I
did. Come on. Let's go doodle each other's names on our arms for our future tattoos.
Baby, that's a great idea.
No, that's a really bad idea.
Number one rule about tattoos is never get your partner's name tattooed on you.
Man.
After the sand, but they just won't fit because there's no balance. But if you have the golf balls and the beads and put them in the jar after the sand, everything will fit. Balance. Right now, she has zero sense of balance and dedicates her entire life to this boy. She's obsessed and so is he.
Wow. That was really deep. Did you get that from a BuzzFeed video?
Something like that.
What are we gonna do? I don't want Sydney to ruin her life.
You know, what Sydney needs, she needs balance.
Well, yeah, you said that.
You see, what we need to do is we need an intervention. We need to stop Sydney from ruining her life.
Ruining her life? What do you mean?
We need to get her out of the clouds. You know, she's just gonna ruin her life. She has OCD.
That neat freak disorder?
No. OCD isn't just about being neat and clean. It's an obsession with something. And your friends are in an OCD relationship.
I guess I never really thought about it that way.
How long have they been dating?
2 months.
And they already call each other the love of my life. Oh, thank God, this is worse than I thought.
How is it worse? I mean, yeah, it's kind of crazy that they're already in love or something, but maybe they're part of that rare group of people that find their soulmates.
Not in love with each other. In love with the idea of each other.
Oh, who am I kidding? I don't believe in soulmates. What am I gonna do? My best friend is in an OCD relationship. How can we help her? I don't want her to ruin her life and give everything up for a boy. I don't think she will she?
Oh, she most definitely will. For God's sake, if he jumps off a bridge, she'll jump in right after him. And that isn't 100% a chance.
I've created a monster.
I'm afraid you did. That's why we need to help her. Your two other side friends, and I will heavily examine every single one of her social media outlets. I'll let you
you guys don't know what you need to do from there.
Okay, when and where?
Friday evening, Thomas Park, 5:30 p.m. Be there, lose your best friend forever.
Do you need my number?
No, no, no. There's no need for that. I'll be able to find you there.
Okay, thank you, Carmen.
Don't thank me yet. Your friend is still playing Tom with that boy. Ugly name. Hold on. I've got to go help Miss Marcy with a cheating husband. Spread the word around to your friends and I'll see you Friday evening.
What does his name have to do with any of this?
So, why exactly are we here again?
Yeah, and who's Carla? She's been going to school with us?
Yes. Guys, Sydney's in an OCD relationship. We've got to help her.
OCD relationship? What is that?
I'll tell you what.
Where did you come from?
My mother's womb. Now, OCD relationship, it's simple. They're obsessed with each other. They claim to be in love, but they're just stupid and young.
You guys have helped your friend from ruining her life.
You know, I have actual OCD.
And I'm not here to talk about you, darling. Your friend is ruining her life right now.
Why do you want to help Sydney so much?
Because I was Demi once. It was 8th grade, and now she's living in Indonesia with her husband.
She's married?
At 14.
Who's she?
Adeline Morphix. We were best friends since preschool. And then this foreign exchange student came from Indonesia. He was my neighbor, and I became friends with him and introduced him to Adeline. After that, I never saw Adeline again. They were OCD in love.
I'm so sorry, Karma.
Well, if this stuff plan doesn't work out, you'll be more sorry for yourself.
Wait, so who are we in this plan?
The extras. We need to heavily examine every single one of her social media outlets. I'll check her Twitter.
I got Instagram.
I've got Snapchat.
Oh, I've got Facebook.
What?
You never know, she might be updating her grandma about her life.
Whatever.
Oh. I got something. She's sat the movies.
What's wrong? Did an ad for Sheltered Puppies come up?
She's seeing Captain Marvel. What is it? She broke our tradition.
An 11-year tradition?
Oh, no, she did not.
Oh, Danny, this is so unfortunate. Oh, I just got a notification. Oh, yes. So, Sydney just tweeted. A beautiful photo with a ring with the caption. My baby just popped the question, so now we're going to a senior location and getting notes. Hashtag I said yes. Oh dear God, they've got major OCD status. They're engaged. Who caused this?
They're 17.
She's gotta be pregnant or something. They've only been dating for 2 months.
Guys, what are we gonna do?
Well, obviously we need to get to the wedding to stop this monstrosity. Too bad she didn't leave the address or something. Most OCD relationship girls are stupid enough to do those things.
I think I know where they're headed, but we've gotta hurry.
Perfect. Now, I'll walk you through the whole breakdown, Danny. You just need to remind Sydney how much you care about her and don't want to make a completely and utterly horrible mistake that'll ruin her for the rest of her life. Because divorce costs a lot of money and legal issues that are too complicated for anybody, really. Also, make sure you tell her how much you miss her.
All right, let's go crash this OCD wedding.
Yeah, so do you two take each other to a death view part or whatever?
I do.
Not the wedding!
Guys, what are you doing here? This was supposed to be secret and private.
It's no secret if you tweet it.
Do I know you?
That's not important right now.
Sid, what is wrong with you?
Hey, there's nothing wrong with my hushy-wushy snuffy kids.
Hey, need I remind you that beautiful name will one day be shared with our first little boy?
Told you she was pregnant.
What is wrong with you? You broke our tradition. You've never done that. This was supposed to be our thing. No, it's not just a movie. This is a friendship that has become distance because you don't know how to handle your relationships with others. When was the last time you even texted one of us when it didn't involve homework?
Hey, are we going to continue the service? Or?
Not now!
Why can't you just understand that Pietro and I are in love?
Because you're not. You're obsessed with each other. You don't even know each other.
Yo, that is false.
When's your birthday?
February 4th.
Baby, you were so close.
Your birthday?
Damn it!
Remember in kindergarten when you were crying because Heather Morse fit threw out your birthday party invitation to see Shrek the Third, and I took that card out of your hand and said that I was coming instead?
Yeah, how could I forget that?
And shortly after, we vowed to never let each other do anything stupid?
Of course.
Well, I'm here sticking to that vow. Look what's going on. You're about to get married to someone you just met 2 months ago. In the stock room of Target.
The girl spits facts.
Scott, what am I doing? What have I been doing? Danny, I'm so sorry that I ditched you for a guy you set me up with 2 months ago.
Shoot me a text whenever you're free to hang out.
You got it!
Well, looks like my work is done here. Thank you, Karma. Really. And you know, if you ever want to hang out.
No.
I don't travel groups. Now, if you'll excuse me, I smell some tension coming from the male's restroom. You know, I'll miss her. Even though she was kind of rude to me, I still don't really know who she is.
Do we got a story for you?